Former Secretary General of the United Nations, Kofi Annan, has died.
Annan, the diplomat from Ghana, served in the UN's top post from 1997 to 2006. In 2001, he was awarded the Nobel Peace Prize along with the entire United Nations. It was for their work for a better organized and more peaceful world. The United Nations Migration Agency tweeted, "A life well lived, a life worth celebrating."
CNN's Richard Roth has a look back at the life of the UN's seventh Secretary General.
I, Kofi Annan.
Kofi Annan was the seventh Secretary General in United Nations history.
Good morning. As you know, this is my first day. It's like first day in school.
Annan received quite an education, serving 10 years at the helm of the United Nations. There were personal highs and lows. From winning the Nobel Peace Prize to failing his fight to stop the U.S. invasion of Iraq. Born in Ghana, Annan's university schooling included the big chill of Minnesota at McAllister College. Kofi Annan spent most of his adult life with the U.N.
Okay, now we go to work.
The man who many simply called Kofi rose to the top after over half a century. Staffers recalled his ability to lead and inspire. Annan did manage to avoid potential career-ending moments while serving in the Department of Peacekeeping. In 1994, the UN Security Council and others, including Annan, were accused by the UN field commander in Rwanda of ignoring his warnings. An estimated 800,000 people died as the world was reluctant to send troops in.
I believed at that time that I was doing my best. But I realized after the genocide that there was more that I could and should have done.
The next year, thousands of Muslims were massacred in Srebrenica as Bosnian Serbs overran a UN safe zone. Annan would later say Rwanda and Srebrenica would shape his global thinking. The Secretary General at the time, Boutros-Boutros-Ghali, would take the heat. U.S. Ambassador Madeleine Albright would block him for a second term as Secretary General. Washington's candidate, Kofi Annan.
I didn't have any such dreams, and it had never happened that somebody from the system was elected Secretary General.
Annan's first term was highly rated. He championed human rights and urged the U.N. to protect civilians if their own governments turned on them. But it was Annan whose charm and style elevated him to international rock star status. The man and the organization accepted the Nobel Peace Prize in 2001, months after 9/11.
We have entered the third millennium through a gate of fire.
It would not be a smooth second term for Annan. Friends of Annan reported he appeared depressed and distant, unable to stop the U.S. invasion of Iraq. He later called the assault illegal.
I think the worst moments, of course, was the Iraq War, which as an organization we couldn't stop, and I really did everything I can to try to see if we can stop it.
A personal nightmare when a suicide truck bomb killed UN Iraq envoy Sergio Vieto de Mello and many UN personnel sent to Baghdad by Annan.
So you can imagine shock when that brutal death of my friends and colleagues happened.
Iraq brought more bad news for Annan. The so-called oil for food UN agreement with Iraq led to corruption. A report later cleared Annan, but his son Kojo was linked to the scandal. The reserved Annan erupted when a reporter pressed him about a mysterious Mercedes tied to his son.
You've been behaving like an overgrown schoolboy in this room for many, many months and years. You are an embarrassment to your colleagues and to your profession.
A warmer engagement on his final day when Annan drew a standing ovation in the General Assembly. He never stopped working for the goals of the global organization Annan spent a lifetime in, a life and career fueled by tragedies and triumphs.
So again, the UN Migration Agency letting us know that Kofi Annan has died at age 80. We just heard from Richard Roth there in that report. He's now on the line with us from New York. Richard, certainly, you've covered the United Nations for many, many years, and Kofi Annan's name was there for many of those years.
Yes, and I knew him when he was the director of UN peacekeeping, even before that. There is no doubt that anybody of a certain age covering the United Nations and following the United Nations for the 10 years when he was Secretary General, the name Kofi Annan is almost larger than life. It's also because the following two UN Secretaries General have, for various reasons, chosen a lower profile route to go. In fact, I dare say that if you went out onto the streets of major cities in the world and you asked who is the current Secretary General of the UN, you would hear, isn't it Kofi Annan? It was a very, of course, always a tumultuous time in the world, but that he started as a Secretary General, I would say, just as the internet was in its infancy and television news coverage of the UN was paramount also then, and print media covering the UN extensively from the UN. And Annan and his team also knew that that was a good way to get the message out, and I think it was good for both sides. Though, yes, he certainly had his critics, and some would say that he was Teflon. As I had just mentioned in that Lifetime report, he was somehow able to move on from being entangled with the Rwanda genocide when he was director of peacekeeping, and later on there were other moments, and you saw his frustration with the Iraq war. But for Kofi Annan, I can tell you personally, you couldn't help but feel like he was a friend. You're supposed to maintain some independence from the people you cover, but I thought it was all genuine, and I traveled around the world with him from Tunisia to East Timor, as it was known then, Timor-Leste, and the man had a touch that people, I think, felt that if he entered a room, he had a way of potentially solving some global crisis. It's obviously much more complicated now, and he wasn't always able to do that. But that was the time in which we were covering him. Natalie, George.
Getting the perspective here from CNN's senior UN correspondent Richard Roth on the phone with us. And again, perspective that we can get so well from you traveling with Kofi Annan, knowing him personally.